Now, what an eventful day it has been politically, because today the BJP blew its poll bugle in right earnest for the Lok Sabha elections, which are to happen in just a few months from now. The first starter is the party released its official campaign song, and this came even as the Prime Minister virtually addressed around 30 lakh first-time voters from across the country. This first-time voter is an important denominator for every political party in this Lok Sabha election, given that in 2019, when the electoral rolls were made for the Lok Sabha polls, there were 15 million new first-time voters on the rolls. By afternoon, the Prime Minister then went to Bulandshahar, where he inaugurated projects worth more than 19,000 crores. And finally, the day was capped by a display of India's global might in the Modi Macron Shobha Yatra in Jaipur. We will talk about the significance, the messaging, and the political importance of each of these three things that has happened today. But first, let's focus on the campaign song itself. The 2-minute, 12-second long campaign theme song talks of issues that have emotional value, like that of the Ram Mandir, but also of India's achievements and the aim of a Viksit Bharat. The idea of the song is to underline all the achievements of the Modi government that include not just articles of faith, like the Ram Temple, and the idea of inclusive and Viksit Bharat. It also showcases India's recent achievements, like its performance in sporting events, like the Asian Games, the Olympics, its achievements in the field of space exploration. So, in 24 hours, three different demographics have been reached by the Prime Minister at the same time. Youth, farmers, and the global citizen, while also honoring the hero of the Ram Mandir. Has that, these, what has happened in the last 12 hours, managed to set the narrative for the 24 elections?
Is kshetra ne to desh ko Kalyan Singh ji jaisa sapoot diya hai, jinhone Ram kaaj aur Rashtra kaaj दोनों के लिए अपना जीवन समर्पित किया। आज वो जहां है, अयोध्या धाम को देखकर बहुत आनंदित हो रहे होंगे। 2017 में डबल इंजन की सरकार बनने के बाद से यूपी में पुरानी चुनौतियों से निपटने के साथ ही आर्थिक विकास को नई गति दी है। आज का कार्यक्रम हमारी इस प्रतिबद्धता का प्रमाण है। अगले 25 साल आपके लिए भी और भारत के लिए भी, दोनों के लिए बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण है। आपको अगले 25 साल अपना और भारत दोनों का भविष्य तय करना है।
So he has spoken to 30 lakh first-time voters. He has spoken of Kalyan Singh, who not just is a hero of the Ram Mandir agitation, but also has a sizable following in his own, the Lodi, the backward community. Meanwhile, let's do a status check on where things lie with the principal opposition alliance. The TMC has already said bye to INDIA, so has the Aam Aadmi Party. The Uddhav Sena is playing hardball for the Maharashtra seat sharing. But most important is the fate of Nitish Kumar. There is rumblings and there is suspense and there is a buzz, but nobody actually knows what is on the mind of Nitish Kumar. Even as we speak right now, there are meetings that are happening at the house of Nitish Kumar, at the house of Tejaswi Yadav, at the house of Amit Shah. There are various houses with our centers of activity, but the mind of Nitish Kumar is a mystery wrapped in an enigma. Could he be the latest leader who at one point wanted to be convener, but now he is going to be on his way out of the Mahagadbandhan yet again.
कल झंडा है ना, कल गणतंत्र दिवस है जी। उसी अवसर पर हम अभी बिहार शरीफ जा रहे हैं, वहाँ के प्रभारी मंत्री हैं, वहाँ कल झंडा फहराए गए हम लोग। और फिर बाकी जो महादलित टोला में भी जाएंगे, अभी तो यही कार्यक्रम है, कोई दूसरा
सरकार में अभी जो बिहार में सब
सरकार में अभी ठीक है, तब तो जा रहे झंडा फहराने।
बीजेपी के लोगों ने दिल्ली में बैठक बुला ली है सब लोग।
अरे बैठक करना तो पार्टियों का काम है,
यहाँ सब कुछ ठीक है बिहार में,
अरे इसीलिए हम झंडा फहराने जा रहे हैं।
कब तक सब ठीक रहेगा?
कोई मीटिंग नहीं है, प्रतिदिन यहाँ पर कार्यकर्ताओं को से मिलते हैं आदरणीय लालू प्रसाद जी, और जो भी पत्रकार साथी यहाँ रहते हैं वो सब जानते हैं कि इतने लोग प्रतिदिन जो कार्यकर्ता हैं आते हैं, अपनी बात रखते हैं। सरकार पूरी मजबूती के साथ बिहार में काम कर रही है, युवाओं के हित में, किसान के हित में, नौजवान के हित में। और पहले किया गया नौकरी का सवाल, बड़ा सवाल, देश में एक मॉडल है बिहार, और राष्ट्रीय जनता दल इस सरकार में मजबूती के साथ नीतीश जी का साथ दे रही है।
दो बड़े बड़े बार्गेनर है, हार्ड बार्गेनर, ये हार्ड बार्गेनिंग चल रहा है, और ये बार्गेनिंग चल रहा है नीतीश बाबू, पहले लालू जी ने डराया, कहा कि उन्होंने कहा कि लालू जी के आशीर्वाद से मुख्यमंत्री हैं, तुरंत उनका मंत्री दिया कि अमित शाह ने कुछ नहीं कहा, तुरंत दूसरे दिन पिता पुत्र घुटना टेक दिया नीतीश कुमार जी के आगे लालू जी, कि वो डरा देते हैं लालू जी को कि मैं मायके चली जाऊंगी, तुम देखते रहियो, लेकिन मायके में कोई जगह नहीं है, माहौल क्रिएट किया है उन्होंने। लालू जी कांग्रेस के मंत्री परिषद में मंत्री थे, रेल मंत्री थे, आज वही गले का घेक बना हुआ है।
All right, so that brings us to the big question of the day. We are just months away from the poll dates being announced. The campaign video is out, but has the BJP put all its bets on Modi ki guarantee, putting all its eggs in one basket? INDI is disintegrating, and has that paved the way for the BJP hat trick that has been predicted by the Prime Minister himself? And has the Prime Minister managed to push all the right buttons with a three-way poll messaging that he did today? Joining us on the debate, we have Sanjeev Verma, national spokesperson of the BJP, senior journalist Amit Chaugankar, Karuna Sagar, national spokesperson of the RJD, Kamar Zaman Chaudhary, political analyst, Dr. Shantanu Sen, MP and national spokesperson of the TMC will be joining us in just a bit. But Sanjeev Verma, I want to start by asking you, pehle you declared that ab ki baar 400 par, then you said that we are coming back, third time ki guarantee. Now you are saying सपने नहीं हकीकत चुनते हैं, सभी लोग मोदी को चुनते हैं, is this over confidence?
You know, Padmaja, I think the BJP has delivered on most of the promises made. So when we say that हम सपने नहीं हकीकत चुनते हैं, इसलिए तो लोग मोदी को चुनते हैं, you know, I think this fits the bill absolutely perfectly, because I think one of the biggest poll manifestos for the longest time of the BJP was मंदिर वहीं बनाएंगे, और वो हमने कर दिखाया. Nobody in their wildest dreams thought that Article 370 would be abrogated. At least I did not think it would happen in my lifetime. It has happened, and how? Then look at the Chandrayaan 3 mission. I think, you know, that historic date in August 2023, we not only became the fourth nation after Russia, USA and China to land on the moon, but the first country globally to land on the South Pole, on the southern side of the moon. Then look at our performance in Asian Games, which the Prime Minister has been talking about, 107 medals, out of which 28 gold. You know, ye kehna, isme to sportsman ki contribution hai. Of course, who's denying that? But okay, who created the enabling ecosystem? Of course, Ram Mandir happened because of that historic judgment on the 9th of November 2019 by the Supreme Court. But who created an enabling Hindu ecosystem? It is Prime Minister Narendra Modi. And look at the abrogation of Article 370. While there are lone wolf incidents which keep happening, let us be very clear, 95% plus a drop in stone pelting incidents, 67% plus in terror incidents. So you can't but give credit to Modi, whether you hate him, you like him, you cannot ignore him.
Okay, you cannot ignore him. Let me take the opening comments now from the RJD. BJP is saying ki sab log Modi ko chunte hain. In the Mahagathbandhan, there is right now suspense over Nitish Kumar kisko chunte hain. We are just breaking news right now, Mr. Karuna Sagar, that Nitish ji is in touch with BJP. He is sitting at one Ane Marg and he is calling up people in BJP.
Thank you, Padmaja. First, as Sanju ji said, well, this government is not about guarantees. This government is about treating electoral promises as gimmicks, as jumla. Now, what happened to 15 lakh rupees in each person's account? What happened to 2 crore jobs each year? What happened to doubling of the farmers' income in by 2022? What happened to bringing back?
Sir, if I may, what happened to Nitish ji?
Who have left the
Nitish ji was abusing the BJP and was standing with his dear bhatijas. Now Nitish Kumar, what has happened to him? First, let's clear that suspense.
No, I'll come to that. But let me, because you started with Sanju ji, so I just wanted to put forward my point of view. Now, what happened to the petroleum prices? What happened to the dollar rupee exchange? The government is so petrified of the unemployment rate that it is not even allowing NSSO to publish the data. It's not allowing CAG to publish the data. On the internal security front, I don't have to talk much about Manipur. You know, it's burning since 3rd of May last year.
Okay.
Now, when it comes to foreign affairs, you see what happens even a small country.
I am
like
granting
Maldives,
you all of this. You are saying that all of the promises are unkept. Let's take you at your face value. Everything is unkept. But then by being in complete disarray, isn't the opposition actually giving a walkover to the BJP despite all their faults, as you claim? How will you manage to hammer home the message of their problems if you yourself cannot decide whether you are together or apart?
You see, my chief spokesperson of the RJD has already spoken and given detailed interview regarding the goings on. And there is absolutely nothing except media imagination and the creation by the kind of media which gets fed by the BJP.
Okay.
And your cameraman who is sitting in front of me was in front of one ANA and Raj Bhavan, and he tells me nothing is happening.
Okay, we'll take your word for it. Chale, Sanju Verma, what is all these canards you are spreading? Nothing is happening. Nitish Kumar is happy. Nitish Kumar Tejaswi ko chunte hain.
Padmaja ji, I will come to your question. I don't want to digress. But since the RJD spokesperson gave out some wrong data, I will take 20 seconds to rebut his lies. Pehli baat, Modi ji ne kabhi ye nahi kaha pointedly that har kisi ke khate mein 15 lakh aayenge. Maybe you are hallucinating. And if you have the proof, please send a WhatsApp to the Times Now media group so that they can put it out on air. Point number two, aapne unemployment ki baat ki, padh likar aaya kijiye. Unemployment rate is at a historic low of 3.2%. Aapne inflation ki baat ki, average inflation under the Modi government in last 9.5 years is 5.4%. That number was 10.7% under the Congress-led UPA. इसलिए कुछ भी आकर यहाँ क्योंकि आपको बोलना है तो जुमलेबाजी आप कर रहे हैं. And I want to ask you one thing. यदि सब कुछ खराब है, अर्थव्यवस्था खराब है, unemployment is touching new highs as per you, inflation is touching new highs as per you, लोग गरीबी और भुखमरी से मर रहे हैं, पर ताज्जुब की बात यह है इतना सब खराब होने के बावजूद मोदी जी आपके हिसाब से कोई काम कर ही नहीं रहे. फिर भी पता ताज्जुब की बात क्या है, आरजेडी है जीरो सीट्स इन द लोकसभा. तो आप कितने निकम्मे हो गए कि इतना सब खराब होने के बावजूद आपकी लोकसभा में एक भी
ओके नो पर्सनल अटैक नो पर्सनल अटैक लेट मी ब्रिंग इन समीर चौगांकर. समीर चौगांकर, हैज द इंडिया let's say not disintegration but their confusion making it a one horse race for the BJP just because दूसरी तरफ आपके इतना chaos मचा हुआ है कि बीजेपी तो अभी भी आराम से कह रही है कि भाई हमारा तो थर्ड टर्म गारंटीड है. वो 2047 की बात कर रहे हैं.
बिल्कुल पद्मा जी, मुझे लग रहा है कि 2024 का जो लोकसभा का चुनाव होने जा रहा है वो बहुत निरस चुनाव होने जा रहा है, क्योंकि सबको पता है, पूरा हिंदुस्तान इस बात को जानता है, 140 करोड़ की पॉपुलेशन हिंदुस्तान की जानती है कि 2024 में प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी तीसरी बार सरकार बनाने जा रहे हैं. आप देखिए, आज प्रधानमंत्री मोदी ने सुबह पहले फर्स्ट टाइम वोटर से बात की, फिर वो बुलंदशहर जाते हैं, वहां पर वो अपनी रैली को करते हैं, उसके बाद वह आज जयपुर के अंदर फ्रांस के राष्ट्रपति के साथ रोड शो कर रहे हैं, रात को देर रात भारतीय जनता पार्टी के नेताओं के साथ बैठक करने वाले हैं। प्रधानमंत्री 24 घंटे सातों दिन काम कर रहे हैं संगठन के लिए, सरकार के लिए, देश के भलाई के लिए, सर्वजन हिताय सर्वजन सुखाय के लिए काम कर रहे हैं। और आप विपक्ष में देखिए, राहुल गांधी बंगाल जाते हैं तो ममता बनर्जी कहती है हम चुनाव अकेले लड़ेंगे, हम इंडिया गठबंधन में लेकिन हम चुनाव अलग लड़ेंगे। पंजाब में आम आदमी पार्टी बोल देती है कि पंजाब में हम गठबंधन नहीं करेंगे, हम चुनाव लड़ेंगे। नीतीश कुमार जो प्रधानमंत्री बनने के लिए जिन्होंने इंडिया गठबंधन बनाने की पूरी कोशिश की थी, जिन्हें संयोजक पद का ऑफर किया था, जिन्होंने ठुकरा दिया, और अब वो वापस भारतीय जनता पार्टी के साथ एनडीए में आने की तैयारी कर रहे हैं। यह बताता है कि इंडिया गठबंधन जमीनी स्तर पर कितना कमजोर है। आज महाराष्ट्र के अंदर एमवीए महाराष्ट्र विकास एमवीए की बैठक हुई थी उद्धव ठाकरे और कांग्रेस के नेताओं की, सीटों के शेयरिंग पे कोई बात नहीं हो पाई है। मुझे लग रहा है इंडिया गठबंधन किसी भी राज्य के अंदर अभी तक सीटों को लेकर सहमति नहीं बना पाया है। बिहार के अंदर लालू और नीतीश इतने दिनों से साथ में, क्या सीटों का गठबंधन हो पाया? और यह सीटों का गठबंधन नहीं हुआ है इसीलिए नीतीश कुमार वापस भारतीय जनता पार्टी के साथ आ रहे हैं। वो जानते हैं कि लालू की सभा चुनाव नहीं जीत पाएंगे। देखिए 2024 के अंदर प्रधानमंत्री मोदी को कोई चुनौती नहीं है, जो अभी आज भारतीय जनता पार्टी का जो निकला और जो भी जो हो रही है कि सबका विश्वास सबका भरोसा ले रहे हैं, और यही कारण है कि प्रधानमंत्री मोदी तीसरी बार सरकार बना रहे हैं।
और बाकियों का भरोसा छोड़िए, डॉक्टर शांतनु सेन, आई कम टू इन सेकंड, बाकियों का भरोसा छोड़िए, टुडे इवन इमैनुअल मैक्रोन हैज बीन गिवन अ रेप्लिका ऑफ द राम मंदिर, दैट्स हिम इन जयपुर बीइंग गिफ्टेड अ रेप्लिका ऑफ अ राम मंदिर। मंदिर मैसेज गोज टू पेरिस। कमरुज़मान चौधरी,
I am not a Nostradamus like Samirji out here, you know, to predict who will be the Prime Minister of India in 2024. But, you know, when you speak eloquent about the Prime Minister, Narendra Modi's government's policies and what not, but then simple as that, why is India at 123rd in the per capita income till date? Why are we at 2 lakh plus crore debt?
Sir, let's talk about strategy. I am giving to you all now, your allegations may be correct. I am purely focusing right now. On poll strategy and messaging. One side you have a poll strategy where a party is saying we are coming for the third term. Now we are going to talk about how it's going to be a global image of India. I am not even dealing with these local elections. I am dealing with India's global image. I am meeting with Macron. I am hobnobbing with Biden. I am talking about Meloni.
Padmaja, I simply fail to
understand. And on the other, you've got a disintegrating alliance. That is the messaging I am compelled.
When a foreign president is visiting India, can he just simply ask the Bharatiya Janata Party as a journalist the simple question? Why is Modi government stonewalling the French judge's investigation into the Rafael scam, into the kickbacks? Why is it so? There is a report out there in the open. Is it not defamation of India? Why has the Prime Minister taken this up with President Macron? Yes or no?
Maybe what Macron said, also has been turned into a Sanghi. He is taking a replica of the Ram Mandir. He is not doing anything on the investigation.
No, I am just asking. No, let me finish. Padmaja, please, this is not fair.
Okay, finish.
I am the punchbag out here right now tonight. So let me just finish. Give me please 2 minutes finish. Time. The second point that you are coming out here, this same Sanju Verma's party were abusing Nitish Kumar the other day. Today, this same turncoat, if he goes to back to NDA, will praise eloquent of it. The same Jagdish Shetter who came back to the BJP today. So you cannot just trust these career politicians. They are after ideologically in India, Padmaja, you are a senior journalist. There is only one block which is fighting ideologically against the BJP and the RSS. Good. And that is the Indian
now
National
this,
Congress.
Sanju Verma, and don't sidestep this question. Is it for BJP a gloves-off election jahan hook, crook by any means possible, saam daam dandabhed? Same Jagdish Shettar, when he left, he said Lingayats have been insulted by the Bharatiya Janata Party. All kinds of things were said about him in the Karnataka election. Today he is being garlanded in the BJP headquarters. Tomorrow it could be Nitish Kumar. Already he has come with you twice. Now he's again going to be welcome. Is it no holds barred, Sanju Verma?
I heard your question, Padmaja.
Yes.
I will say this. If you look at the history, and any journalist, including you, I will add, you're not just a senior, you're a consummate journalist. You know, but now let me come to the moot point. You know, aapki aajkal itni tareef ho rahi hai Padmaja ji, kahin hum BJP wale peeche na reh jaye. But you know, on a more serious note, I have this to say. जब नितिन ऑन योर डिबेट आई एग्री विद कमरू जमान एंड आई हैड कॉल्ड हिम कि ये तो पलटू चाचा है नीतीश कुमार, मैं तो आज भी कहूंगी ये पलटू चाचा है क्योंकि जिस तरफ बहाव होता है ये उसी तरफ इनका झुकाव होता है. Having said that, what is the larger game plan of the BJP? Point number one, and I say this without any qualms whatsoever, it is always winnability. Winnability matters because यदि आप चुनाव जीतेंगे ही नहीं तो आपका जो vision है आप उसका करेंगे क्या? So Prime Minister's extraordinary vision and flawless execution has always happened because this is coupled with the winnability quotient which the BJP never compromises on as long as there is not too much of an ideological difference. Jagdish Shettar ji gaye the naraz hokar abhi keh rahe hain ki Congress mein mujhe koi future nahi nazar aa raha, mujhse galti ho gayi, welcome me back into your arms. We said fine. This way I want to ask you, Siddaramaiah is not a congressman. Siddaramaiah to dusri party mein aati party mein aaye na JDS se, aapne to unko welcome kiya. If you can welcome Siddaramaiah, if Sonia Gandhi can join hands with Uddhav Thackeray despite the fact that for his lifetime Uddhav Thackeray's father Bala Saheb Thackeray always said main zinda chahe rahu na rahu mar jaunga par kabhi Sonia Gandhi ke sath haath mein haath milakar alliance mein nahi aaunga. But what has his son done? Uddhav Thackeray is hobnobbing with Sonia Gandhi. So Sonia Gandhi can ally with Uddhav Thackeray. Siddaramaiah, an ex-JDS person, can be welcomed and made a chief minister by the Congress for the second or third time. But we should not welcome Nitish Kumar.
So you got all of the JDS. You said, why should we import one JDS person like Siddaramaiah? We will get all of the JDS only into our alliance. Before Kamru Zaman Chaudhary answers the winnability criteria, Dr. Shantanu said, this is seeming very worrying. If the BJP is declaring winning is what matters, we will accept anyone who doesn't have a great ideological divide as long as they are winnable. I hope tomorrow you are not going to be shaking hands with the BJP. I mean, you have been friends in the past.
You know, Trinamool Congress being the third largest political party and the second largest opposition in the parliament, both inside and outside, Trinamool Congress is that political party which always fights BJP head on. And whenever there was any fight between BJP and Trinamool, Trinamool Congress has also won. And BJP is so much scared of Trinamool Congress, that's why in our state of West Bengal, almost each and every Trinamool Congress leader, they are being harassed by ED and CBI, being instructed by the central BJP. That's why Trinamool Congress-run Bengal government is being deprived of so many central funds. That's why especially Trinamool Congress MPs are being suspended in the parliament for raising voice against corruption. That's why Trinamool Congress leaders and Trinamool Congress workers are being brutally assaulted by the BJP goons. And it proves once again that Trinamool Congress is the party which can fight back BJP, which can defeat BJP, and BJP suffers from Trinamool phobia. It is crystal clear. That's why the main target of BJP is Trinamool Congress. So but far, you know, the opposition Dr. political
Sen,
parties are concerned.
Let me remind you that in September 22, Mamata Banerjee, not ABC, Mamata Banerjee herself said that not all of RSS is bad. Some of their ideals is very good. That is the reason that Adhir Ranjan Chaudhary had said that the real B team of BJP is the Trinamool Congress. That's what makes me wonder. That ultimately, if winnability is the quotient, who knows, tomorrow you also may do business. Who had thought that HD Devagoda will do business? Who had thought Jagdish Shettar would go back? Nitish Kumar is on the verge of going back. Maybe you'll also
I would like to answer your question.
Go on, Dr. Sen.
I would like to answer your question, like all the BJP spokesperson are not the lady versions of Mungeri Lal, as I find some bodies. Similarly, Madam Mamata Banerjee has also said this before, that this BJP being run by Narendra Modi and Amit Shah is not that BJP which was used to be run by Atal Bihari Vajpayee and Lal Krishna Advani. It was also said by Madam Mamata Banerjee. There is a hell and heaven difference.
Okay, now hell of a difference. BJP but before Sanju Verma aggressively wants to respond, now, but I have one more piece of developing news. So I want to ask you that also. Who right now is a bigger enemy for you? This is what we are learning, that Rahul Gandhi today has entered Bengal in Kuch Bihar. The district administration, we are being told, is not giving permission to his program in Siliguri on the 28th of January because they're saying that day there is an examination in Siliguri. So right now, if we are, you know, measuring animus, you seem to have a greater animus towards Rahul Gandhi and his Bharat Jodo Yatra than towards the BJP.
That's a separate deal. No one is above law. Even our own party, if they want to have a program and if there is some law and order situation or if there is an examination, administration might not give permission. Because here in the state of West Bengal, the administration works absolutely neutrally. Unlike the other BJP ruled states, there lies the basic difference.
Okay.
Rahul Gandhi is holding his own program. There's a program of a separate political party. There's a separate issue that our party supremo was not informed in a proper manner. There's a separate deal.
Okay. But so Sanju Verma, just because they are fighting the Congress doesn't mean that they are your friends. Dushman ka dushman har cheez mein dost nahi hota. They will fight you, they will defeat you, and who knows, they'll have a post-poll alliance, Sanju Verma.
Okay. Now, Padmaja, I heard, you know, this gentleman very patiently. Inhone mere upar tippani bhi ki, you did not interject him. I like that because I'm pretty capable to defend myself. Aapne kaha yahan par lady spokesperson Mungeri Lal ke haseen sapne dekh rahi hai. So I want to remind Mr. Shantanu Sen, I was with him on a debate yesterday also. And he said that the BJP lives in a fool's paradise. So sir, Mark Twain ki ek bahut mashhoor kahawat hai. It is better to keep quiet and let people assume that you are intelligent rather than opening your mouth and removing every doubt about the fact that actually you are a fool. And that is the category that you belong to because aap mujhe kehte hain that, you know, hum Mungeri Lal ke haseen sapne dekh rahe hain. Mr. Shantanu Sen, in April 2023, your party, the TMC, lost its national party status. In February 2023, there were elections in Tripura. And I remember you, Mamata Banerjee, Abhishek Banerjee, your Sushmita Deb, who also I was in a debate with yesterday, said, kuch bhi ho jaye, BJP Tripura to dobara nahi jeetegi, the TMC will form a government. And do you know something? BJP got 32 seats in Tripura. And how many seats did your TMC win? Zero seats. Mamata Banerjee has zero presence outside Bengal. Padmaja, 10 seconds. In 2022 Goa assembly elections, again Mamata Banerjee was thumping her chest. And from every rooftop in Goa, she was screaming and saying, "Is baar Goa mein BJP ka supra saaf hoga. TMC will form the government." How many seats did the BJP win in Goa? We formed a government on our own. How many seats did the TMC win in Goa? Again, zero. So, आपका वजूद सिर्फ बंगाल तक लिमिटेड है. ममता बनर्जी हैज नो प्रेजेंस आउटसाइड बंगाल. द सूनर यू रियलाइज इट द बेटर इट इज.
ओके डॉक्टर सेन, क्विकली रिस्पॉन्ड देन कमरू जमान चौधरी एंड लेट मी रिमाइंड यू दैट वी आर टॉकिंग टुडे ऑफ द पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ नीतीश कुमार एंड जगदीश शेट्टार रिटर्निंग. बट बिफोर दैट देर हैज बीन मिलिंद देओरा. इन जस्ट द लास्ट वन मंथ देर हैज बीन अशोक तंवर हु वेंट अ फुल सर्कल, वेंट फ्रॉम कांग्रेस टू आम आदमी पार्टी. आम आदमी पार्टी हैज कम टू बीजेपी एंड वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट ऑल ऑफ दीज डिफेक्शंस फ्रॉम महाराष्ट्र टू हरियाणा to now what is happening in Bihar. Dr. Shantanu Sen.
Now, prior to that, I would, with all humility, I would, as a doctor, I'd advise my BJP representative some voice test in the coming days. That might give you some relief.
Sir, please. No
so
personal
judgment. So far our state of West Bengal is concerned, I have told you once again, that here Trinamool Congress is the only party which can take BJP head on and which can defeat BJP, number one. Number two, you know, BJP is so much scared of this India Alliance that they have started doing their old practice. They have started practicing that horse trading policy and all. And you know, the more we approach towards election, these type of activities will be increased by Bharatiya Janata Party. Because they know they are gradually they are losing their ground. And they know it very well that they are nowhere in the entire South India. That's why prior to 22nd January program, Narendra Modi, our learned publicity master, Prime Minister, had to visit the temple specially of southern part of the
okay,
India.
Okay, sir, you're again needling on an issue that has been scared. Spoken about repeatedly in the past. Now we'll talk about Puducherry, we'll talk about Karnataka. We've addressed that. I want to bring in Sameer Chaugankar on the limited issue. You know, when the BJP says winnability is the criteria, अब हमारा एम है 400 पार. अब उसके लिए अगर हमें चाहिए होगा तो शेट्टा चाहिए होगा, तो नीतीश कुमार चाहिए होगा, तो कोई और भी. ऑल इज फेयर इन लव एंड वार. समीर जी, द वोटर Does the voter accept it is my question. At some point, थोड़ी सुचिता वाली बात कहीं आती नहीं है, समीर जी?
नहीं, मुझे लगता है देयर इज नथिंग रॉन्ग इन इट. अगर कोई पॉलिटिकल पार्टी किसी अपोजिट पॉलिटिकल लीडर को अपनी पार्टी में लेकर आती है और वो जो पार्टी में आता है, अगर वो पार्टी के चाल चरित्र और चेहरे, पार्टी के डिसिप्लिन में रहता है, पार्टी के आइडियोलॉजी को मानता है, पार्टी के डिसिप्लिन को मानता है, तो मुझे लगता है उसमें कुछ गलत नहीं है.
बट उसका फायदा क्या है? पार्टी के अंदर कोई पॉलिटिकल लीडर गाली देके गया है आपके पास लिंगायत वोट के लिए. विजेंद्र को आपने बीजेपी प्रेसिडेंट बना दिया, आपके पास येदुरप्पा ऑलरेडी है, तो जगदीश शेट्टार की क्या जरूरत है?
लेकिन ये भी लेकिन जगदीश शेट्टर की तीन फैमिली के तीन पूर्वज भारतीय जनता पार्टी और जनसंघ के साथ जुड़े हुए. उनके दादाजी जनसंघ के मेयर रहे हैं कर्नाटका के अंदर, उनके फादर जनसंघ के अंदर और संघ के अंदर रहे, पूरा परिवार जनसंघ और भारतीय जनता पार्टी से जुड़ा हुआ है, आरएसएस से जुड़ा हुआ है. अगर उनको टिकट नहीं मिला और वो नाराज होकर कुछ समय की पार्टी छोड़कर चले जाते हैं, तो इसका मतलब यह तो नहीं है कि भारतीय जनता पार्टी के आइडियोलॉजी जुड़े हुए. उमा भारती भारतीय जनता पार्टी छोड़कर चली गई थी, उमा भारती से बड़ा कोई भारतीय जनता पार्टी का सपोर्टर रहा है क्या? वह नाराज हुआ, भारतीय जनता पार्टी छोड़कर चली गई थी, अपनी पार्टी बनाई थी, लौट के वो भारतीय जनता पार्टी के अंदर आ गई. तो ऐसे बहुत एग्जाम्पल है भारतीय राजनीति के अंदर, जब भारतीय जनता पार्टी से नाराज होकर लोग जाते हैं और लौट के भारतीय जनता पार्टी के अंदर आते हैं. मुझे लगता है इसमें कुछ भी गलत नहीं है. आज भारतीय जनता पार्टी देश ही नहीं दुनिया की सबसे बड़ी पॉलिटिकल पार्टी है. और आज जब प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी के नेतृत्व में और अमित शाह के संगठन के कौशल के अंदर जब भारतीय जनता पार्टी 400 सीटें जीतने की तैयारी कर रही है और 50% से ज्यादा वोट बैंक की तैयारी कर रही है, तो मुझे लग रहा है प्रधानमंत्री मोदी का जिस तरीके से 2 साल का कार्यकाल रहा है, हर पार्टी का नेता चाहता है कि देश के अंदर जो विकास हो रहा है प्रधानमंत्री मोदी के नेतृत्व के अंदर, सबका साथ सबका विकास और सबका विश्वास जो हासिल हो रहा है, उसमें सब शामिल होना चाहते हैं और भारतीय जनता पार्टी के साथ जुड़ना चाहते हैं, भारतीय जनता पार्टी के साथ आना चाहते हैं, इंडिया का हिस्सा बनना चाहते हैं. तो देयर इज नथिंग रॉन्ग इन इट.
ओके, देयर इज नथिंग रॉन्ग इन वांटिंग टू बी ऑन द विनिंग साइड. एंड हाउ डज वन डिसाइड व्हिच इज द विनिंग साइड? बाय लुकिंग एट हु हैज गॉट दैट पॉलिटिकल मैसेजिंग टुगेदर. नाउ कमरू जमान चौधरी, यू आंसर दिस, बट बिफोर दैट आई वॉन्ट टू शो यू सम डेटा. वन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट पोलिटिकल मैसेजिंग, द प्राइम मिनिस्टर स्टार्टेड हिज डे टुडे बाय टॉकिंग टू 30 लाख फर्स्ट टाइम वोटर्स. वाई डिड ही रीच आउट टू फर्स्ट टाइम वोटर्स? Let's take a look at the electoral rolls and what the number of first-time voters this time around is. In Maharashtra, which has a total electorate of 9.12 crores, first-time voters are 10.18 lakhs. In Bihar, 7.6 crore total electorate, first-time voters are 9.2 lakhs. Moving on to Andhra Pradesh, out of 4.08 crores, you've got 5.2 lakh first-time voters. And in the fourth state that we are talking about is Kerala, you've got 2.88 lakh first-time voters out of a total of 7.6 crores. The point I'm trying to make is, here is a party that is sitting there and saying that we will reach out to these 15 million people alone because this also is important for our election. As opposed to another party which is saying, tu aisa, tu vaisa, सुबह को गाली, शाम को पोस्टर फाड़ दिए, कोई स्लोगनियरिंग कर रहा है, एक्सेट्रा. विच साइड वुड यू वांट टू बी ऑन?
पद्मजा, यू नो व्हेन द गोइंग इज इन योर फेवर, एवरी डैम थिंग यू डू गोस इन योर फेवर. दैट्स अ कॉमन सेइंग. आई एम नॉट एग्जैक्टली गोइंग इनटू व्हाई प्राइम मिनिस्टर मोदी इज एड्रेसिंग द फर्स्ट टाइम वोटर्स, बट यू नो द प्लैंक ऑफ भारतीय जनता पार्टी, देयर आर बेसिकली टू प्लैंक्स इफ यू डिस्कस इट. वन इज the nationalism, we call it as pseudo nationalism, and another one is the the Hindutva plank. And the stated goal and objective of the RSS is to catch them young, radicalize them into pseudo nationalism and Farzi Rashtravad, along with the Hindutva, bring them into the fold of divisive politics and indoctrinate them into voting for the BJP. That's the mantra that the Bhatiya Janata Party is trying, and it is trying, playing very good in that.
So no, then you catch them young and you indoctrinate them into so-called secularism and liberalism. Voters are there, you catch them.
Padmaja, it's not that Congress party has got 22 crore voter as of now. So it's nothing new that the Congress party has not caught the young voters. But what we wanted is from this country is a society based on equality, on fraternity that the constitution provides us.
Okay.
You have the chief minister of a country who said, we do not need MIA votes. We do not need, the Rahul Gandhi's Yatra has gone through the MIA territories. What does the elected constitutional head of a state mean by this state?
Okay, we will come to that in just a second.
Wait, you know, Padmaja,
okay,
please.
Final 30 seconds.
You happen to be the chief minister in any time other than this present time, you'd have been dismissed by now.
We will come to the Mea votes in just a second. Final word on this topic, Sanju Verma. You know, the beauty about success is that it has many fathers. Then everything seems like a masterstroke. Oh, first-time voters, masterstroke. Bulandshahr, masterstroke. Emmanuel Macron, also masterstroke.
Okay. Now, Padmaja ji, you know, you have three people from the opposition. They've still not been able to make any coherent point, be that as it may. You know, I want to say something. Kamru Zaman said, you know, catch them young and then radicalize them. I want to remind him, and your audience needs to know, Revanth Reddy, the current chief minister of Telangana from the Congress, is actually an ABVP worker. For the longest time, he was with the BJP. So, aap ye kehna chahte hain ki Revanth Reddy ko ABVP mein grooming BJP ne di, and then a radicalized Revanth Reddy was welcomed by Sonia Gandhi and Rahul Gandhi. Kehre, radical Revanth Reddy ji, though you have RSS roots, though you have BJP connection, we welcome you as the chief minister of Telangana. So please think before you talk. You speak a lot of gibberish. You don't even know about your own chief minister. One of the few states you are in power in is a BJP grassroots worker, though today he's in the Congress. Now let me note one very important point, Padmaja. Please, let me finish.
But as a aside, let me also remind you that some of Rahul Gandhi's closest friends are also now in the BJP.
Exactly.
So radicalize or de-radicalize to ho hi jate na. That is the beauty. Exactly. Like you said, winnability is what matters. I'm going to have to end it over here because we really have to address the other big issue that Kamru Zaman Chaudhary raised. And thank you very much, all gentlemen, Sanju Verma, for joining me on Debate 1.